Tonight is March 31st, and if you've gone online today, you might have seen a few posts about what this day is. Across the world, it is Trans Visibility Day, a day where you will see support from some in politics, in entertainment, sports, you name it, for our trans community. The day was created 12 years ago as a way to shift the focus on our trans family to one of celebration and not one of being victims of hate or violence. In thinking about who to talk to today, my mind immediately went to the Waits family and their trans child, Kit. Kit was outed by a group of parents on Facebook last fall in Hastings, Minnesota, who wanted to oust Kit's mom from a school board seat. It was ugly and cruel, forcing the Waits family to move away as they feared for Kit's safety. But that is not the end of this story. When I sat down with Chris and Kelsey Waits last year, it was 4 days after their family story was told to a national audience.
I can't unsee the things that have been sent to me.
The messages on Facebook were what she couldn't unsee then, outing her 8-year-old child, Kit, as transgender. The messages were cruel, intimidating, and scary. This is Kit's mom, Kelsey, today.
For me, looking back, it's a blur.
Looking back on the pain of that true story that had them pack up and leave Hastings.
I love you.
That brought them to the town's riverbank before they went to see nearly 1,000 people rally in Kit's honor. None of it was easy for any of them. None of it was easy for Kelsey.
In February, I had been diagnosed with PTSD. It had gotten to the point where I couldn't look at photos of the old house. I couldn't go into Hastings to visit friends. Just panic and fear related to all of it.
But pain continuing isn't all that came in these last 4 months.
Taking care of other people and being an advocate in this work is also taking care of me, that it allows me to work on making things better, not just for other people, but for my kid.
Last week, on Kit's 9th birthday, Kelsey co-founded and launched the Transparent Alliance, an organization for parents and caregivers of trans and non-binary kids to come and ask questions or get support or learn about the moment their kid comes out.
The first piece of advice for a parent to go to their kid and do is what?
Love them. You just love them. Every piece of them. That's the most important thing your child needs to know. It's not that you love them in spite of their identity. It's that you love them as a whole person, every ounce of them. And you always will.
That unconditional love can keep them safe at home, and that safety can help them navigate a country and a society that isn't always kind to them. And you see, that last part, worrying about the cruelty, that's what shook Kelsey when Kit came out to her.
For me, when Kit came out, I cried. And I didn't cry because I was sad that they were transgender. For me, it hurt because I knew what this meant they would be going through. And the tears were not for who they were. The tears were for what society was going to put them through.
What a few parents in their former town of Hastings put them through last year. But again, last year is a past year. For Kelsey, last year was the fight for her kids' visibility and rights. This year, her fight is for all the rest.
At this point, our story is out there. We're already out. And so if we can use our voices and speak up and push for change, it means that other people who are not in as safe of a place don't have to, that we can help be that voice for them.
The Transparent Alliance, that group, is online right now on social media and its own page. It's free, and it has a really quick and easy beginner guide for parents and really anybody caring for trans or non-binary children. You can check it out anytime you need it at thetransparentalliance.org.